walking out here into the old garage. The old garage. Lots of stuff in the garage, right? And we're going to go down to this drawer. Bottom drawer. At the bottom of here. We're going to get a vacuum gauge out. Oh, vacuum gauge, where are you? Is my vacuum gauge? Oh, no. This is... What is that? Where's my vacuum gauge? Hey, vacuum gauge. All right. All right, so... Vacuum gauge. This side says fuel pressure, but it's in PSI. And what's interesting about that is I could actually hook this simple gauge. There's no wires. It just works on pressure. Right now it's on zero because atmospheric pressure where I am and where you are is 14.7, but this is actually called PSIG, which is gauge pressure, which is zero. And if you ask a fish what it's like, what do they breathe? They're going to say, I don't know. I just breathe. Which means the fish doesn't know it's in water. We don't really know we're in air. We don't know what our pressure is. So we just kind of call it zero because it's what we're used to. But there's actually 14.7 pounds per square inch on top of us. And we would find that out if we went out into outer space. So the pressure side is pressure. This side is vacuum or suction. Okay, and when we talk about 15 inches of vacuum, that means that the needle would be there on the 15. If we're talking about 21 inches of vacuum, it means it would be there on the 21. Okay, all right, so now that we have an idea. By the way, the pressure on this side, it says fuel pressure because back in the day when we had carburetors, when people had toolboxes that looked like that, that's not my toolbox. That's my toolbox. Anyway, cars with carburetors had very low fuel pressure. You could use one of these gauges to measure fuel pressure. If you put this on a modern fuel injected car, this thing would just go bink and then fuel would spray out of it and it would start to fire. So we don't use that for that. Okay. Pause that. Up to this and I'm going to put it in my mouth. And if I blow. One pound of pressure is really actually quite a lot. But what's interesting is suction is a lot easier.
Negative pressure. You can. So I suck like I'm breathing through a straw. To about there.
I had it with my tongue. Anyway, you can see how fast it reacts. So let's figure out how this thing actually works. All right, first I apologize for what you're going to hear that sounds like pops and bangs. There is construction going on next door to my garage. And so you'll hear people talking in the background, and I apologize. Anyway, let's get some drawings going here. So I'm going to draw a simple intake for a car. And I'm going to draw out here. This is going to be my air filter. So that's my air filter out here. I then have a hose that attaches the air filter to a mass airflow sensor. These wires that go off to the computer. And then I have another hose. Sometimes the math can be in the air filter housing. That's okay. It's not always a separate box. So just be aware that all this plumbing has to be attached and tight. And then this is going to come up to a throttle plate. And I'm going to draw the throttle plate sideways in the intake manifold like that. And then this would actually go down into the valves on the intake manifold attached to the engine. Okay, there we go. So I'm gonna illustrate this with two vacuum gauges. We're gonna put one vacuum gauge is gonna be behind, and this is important, the vacuum gauge always has to be behind where the throttle plate is on the intake. And this would attach with a little plug. There might be a cap, I might take off a gauge. I may take off a vacuum line that might go to a fuel pressure regulator or some emissions component. You're going to want to plug it so it's not just floating. And then you're going to want to stick it, hook it back up. Sorry, there's mosquitoes out here. Anyway, right now, if the engine were running, this needle would be pointing at, like we said, somewhere between 15
to about 21 inches of mercury. And it's important that it's behind the throttle plate. That's like totally key, okay? Now, just for illustrative purposes, you wouldn't normally do this, but let's just say that we had another vacuum gauge and we were able to tap in out here. And this one is going to be reading zero. 0 inches of mercury. And you might say, why is this one reading zero and this one reading suction on this side? I'll make a zero mark there. So that's 0 inches right there. Right now, if the engine's running, this throttle plate is acting like the divider between what is high pressure out here, which is where you and I are. We're certainly not in the engine. And then this is low pressure. And it's a low pressure because you have the intake on the intake stroke of when the piston goes down. Each one of these cylinders is taking a breath. It's drawing air into the cylinder. So normally a functioning engine when it's idling should be around 15 to 21. That's a healthy measurement of an engine atmospheric pressure creating a low pressure cell drawing air into the cylinders. Now what happens is there's a situation called Watt. What is he talking about? W-O-T is wide open throttle. That's when you mash your foot to the floor and step on the gas. That's wide open throttle. So what happens is when we mash our foot on the gas and we go to wide open throttle, this needle is going to change and suddenly read 0 HG. Why? Well, the answer is out here in the universe where you and I are, well, on Earth, atmospheric pressure, not the universe, it's zero. And all of this air is trying to get pulled into the engine. Obviously, the engine is much smaller than the air around it, and therefore, it can't pull all of the air in at once. There's plenty of air to go around. Let's all be thankful that there's plenty of air to go around. Anyway, at this point, this needle will reach zero because the atmospheric pressure between here, outside the throttle plate, and here is now equal. So the gauge goes to zero. Now, in terms of a turbocharged engine, if we start to pressurize this intake with a turbocharger, and a turbocharger would have an air filter, the turbo would be here, and we're pressurizing all of this, what's going to happen is I'm going to start to move this towards PSI, or boost pressure. And let's say that we'll go to 10 PSI. And now I'm not pressurizing atmospheric air, my turbocharger. Well, I don't have it in the diagram, but let's say the turbocharger is somewhere between here, the turbo, and the air filter. And we're going to be pushing air now outside of the turbo into the intake, and I'm now generating boost. That vacuum gauge that I showed is the same thing as a boost pressure gauge that you would have in a turbocharged car. It's just dampened a little better so the needle doesn't jump around and be as distracting. But there you go. That's how a vacuum gauge works.